I remember coming up with the idea for Highcliff Killer 1 with Joe, actually. We were in some tech class, and I had said, hey, how about we, you know, what if we made this feature film or something? He said, he's like, all right, so established him being leading man. I had seen him act before, so we went out and shot the opening scene with Ryan Swakowski, and he just wanted to do that one scene and then be killed, and we did that, and that's kind of what I pitched. I showed it to my friends, and people liked it, and then they wanted to get in. That's basically how I cast it, is people who, you know, who wanted to be in it.
Well, what I remember most about the first film is the fact that we complained and whined a lot, and every time we tried to film a scene, there was about six or seven people there that weren't a part of it, and they always caused trouble because they wanted to go out and do something else. From Highcliff Killer 1, I remember I was not even supposed to have the part that I did. I was supposed to die off right away, which would have been quite unfortunate, because I wanted to be in the movie. But the original guy, Ben Nock, he showed lack of interest.
That's how Steve became, you know, one of the leading men in the second one.
The villager came and did an interview with Nino, and put an article in the newspaper before the film was even done being shot, so we had to kind of speed things up after that to make sure to get it out. Plus, also at school, we had like a flyer type thing that we made in a class, and we put that out pretty early too. So we're kind of advertising it before it even happened.
By the time the premiere came around, I didn't know whether people were gonna like it, because the Highcliff Killer 1 as a whole was very iffy. Plus, my camera broke down, and I'd use my friend's camera, and I lost a lot of the footage, and just things happened, but people actually liked it. And then I looked over at Joe, and I'm like, we should make a sequel.
Always wanted to do a sequel, because we kind of left it open. We just got to discuss in the second movie and what we would do, all the things that we would do different.
Adam and Eric, who was Vinny, had been both very difficult towards the end of the first one. So when it came time to, all right, what we should do is we should kill off one of them right away. And, you know, it turned out that Adam started wanting to be in it more and more, and Blumberg wanted to be in it less. So we took care of Blumberg, and there was Theo.
From there, I guess we kind of just put it into action. We saw a lot of each other in the weight room in the summer. So we got the idea, and one weekend we decided that we were going to go shoot it at Hartman Creek. Did most of the filming there with me, Tony, Nick, and Nino. Nino wasn't in it, so he did all the camera work.
For the majority of the film, we were actually filming from a campsite, which was a really good time. We had a lot of fun. Did a lot of solid shooting, but it was still a really good time.
What I liked about making the second one, as opposed to making the first one, was that we had the people that we needed to do the scene. They were all there. We shot it over most of it over two, three days. And so basically it was like our whole agenda there was to do the movie. It was like get the movie done. We were all excited to do it, so it wasn't like a chore or anything. But we spent basically most of the day working on it. And the beach was down the road, and then the bridge was nowhere near anything. I don't know, we just kind of drove around in the van all day and kind of brought all those things together to make it seem like it was all in one to our little tent. I guess that kind of created better flow, I think, in the movie, until the end.
By the end of the weekend, we just wanted to kill each other.
Somebody must be mimicking my brother from 6 months ago. I could have swore you said you were going to say it.
Yeah, I did. And I was just waiting for him to put the camera on me.
Why? You don't have to have the camera on you to say something. We started really, really going at each other when we got home. You can kind of tell in that scene that we all just want to get the hell out of there.
But the cast, I thought, worked very well. Joe, as Tim, was great because he had that level. I mean, he knew what to do, really. Like, he was pretty believable. Adam Thiel's always fun to work with. Adam is by far the funniest man I know. Like, if I'm ever in a bad mood, I can either watch The Simpsons or I can talk to Adam Thielen. I had worked with him my whole life. Actually, the first thing ever movie we ever made, we were like in fifth grade, was like this 2-hour-long karate fight that me and Thiel were in, and that was, I mean, I've been doing movies with him for so long, so you gotta have him in there. So Tony Spey, I had done a little short with him for a movie, and he did a very, very nice job, I thought. Tony as an actor is very unique in the sense that he puts a lot to the film. He's kind of that kind of weirdish guy, like the things he'd say, which was very good for the part. Plus, you know, then you have Nick, who's like a bigger dude, looks like a runner. He was real fast. And it looked like they were a gay couple. Like the introduction, they were frolicking in the field. Actually, in the original, halfway through, they decided that they didn't want to be gay anymore and that we should start giving them lines about the girlfriend, which they did in the original, you know. But this time around, I edited all that out, so they are completely gay.
My favorite scene in the movie would probably be the dream scene. It was my favorite scene basically because I got to jump off the bridge in my clothes a couple of times and just kind of act like I was running away and falling in into this water, which was pretty cool. And then when I saw it in the movie, what Nino did with it was like three different jumps, all from different angles. He kind of took those, put them together, and slowed it down into a slow motion type thing. And that was like the coolest thing I've ever seen Nino do with a camera before.
My favorite scene was the waterfall scene. It was really fun to work with the water and to have the action all going around us. There was a lot of nice effects added into that scene. It was fun to pretend that I was actually being pulled through the waterfall, when in fact it wasn't quite that deep. In reality, it was 3 or 4 inches deep. A thing that I didn't enjoy about the waterfall scene was falling off of the waterfall onto the hard rocks. You see, it's just not as deep as you would think.
Definitely the favorite scene was when Tim stopped over after being in his house forever, and well, no, we just couldn't make the movie. We couldn't continue. Everything was too funny. I could not pull myself together. I had Joe sitting there, and I had myself. And when I had to talk, I could not pull myself together. It was absurd.
Sorry. Okay, I'm sorry.
Remember again,
classic Theo.
Stop it.
Darn.
Shut it off. He's not gonna be able to do it.
Why is it
funny?
You're...
Why? Why are things funny? So I just go what I want. Is it rolling?
Yep.
Just going. I'm good.
All right. You remember what you're saying?
Come on, Bessie.
You go.
I'm trying.
Like, I couldn't do it for the life of me. Everything was funny. The scene that I enjoyed filming the most was probably the scene where we were at the beach. Just because we went there and Nino basically said, you're just out to show that you're having a good time, so just go out, do anything. And a bunch of people were watching us. It was kind of like Tom Green's situational humor. I think we have some of that in the film, actually. Like, all the lifeguards were staring at us. These little kids were yelling at us, swearing at us, and it was pretty fun.
No doubt in my mind, the least favorite scene that we had to do was the final scene of number 2. Simply because the director, Nino Aldi, let me sit in bugs.
Adam Thiel's afraid of bugs.
Adam Thiel hates bugs.
I'm not a fan of bugs, and he made me sit there, and I didn't want to. I didn't want to do it. There was a bunch of bugs, there were crawly bugs crawling all over my clothes. I didn't enjoy it.
You wouldn't sit down for more than like 2 minutes.
I mean, he's stomping away. He was not excited. He's, you know, like, he had a bad. He was sitting down, but then you look over and Tony Spey was laying there. His head was in the stuff, and he didn't care. But it was funny though.
Then, when I finally would get it right and I wouldn't screw up after sitting in the bugs, someone else would screw up. I'd have to sit in the bugs even longer. Which displeased me even more and more. Every time. Every time.
Ready? We gotta go. We gotta get this done. Yeah, we gotta get this done. Well, let's talk while I'm sitting and eating my bugs. Just go. Just go. And fall back.
Just. Alright.
Fall on your ass.
Don't just say outright. Stare right there on camera. The damn like. At that moment, I wish I wouldn't have done the movie. That's the point I was at.
And won't ever be in another production again. Because he makes me crawl on bugs.
Feels afraid of bugs.
I hate bugs.
Yes. That's right, freshman. Big, tough, senior Adam Thiel in a full bodysuit is afraid of spiders.
Damn! Look at all I'll show it! I'll show it! All
just a bunch of them, and I just didn't like it. So I wish we didn't have to do that scene.
Nick, he was a horrible driver.
I'm not a good driver. Or at least I wasn't when I was 16 years old or 17 when we did it.
I'd be sitting in the passenger seat, and I'd see all this brush come flying up at my face, and it's like these long grass, and he didn't even know he was doing it. He's still driving, and I remember grabbing the wheel like three times. Or he'd be, or Joe and Joe would be in the back seat with Tony, and he'd have one arm on the wheel, and then he'd kind of turn back and start talking like this, and I, you know.
Other mistakes include me not really paying attention to the actual what had to be done to get the movie done. I was just kind of going through the scenes. Sometimes I'd walk too fast. I don't know. We had a good time joking about that.
It's a good swim.
Oh, yeah. Refreshing.
Okay, we're going to have to walk slow.
I said walk slow because I can't
we stop. We don't walk that slow.
Fuck me. Speed up, man.
Yeah, see, first of all, I have 2-inch legs. Second of all, I'm walking backwards to the camera.
Like this because that's all normal. Cool. He's going to be moving back to
you guys.
Okay. I don't want to be that far away, though.
And then you talk about the cards, and then I'll stop and I'll turn around. Right.
Action.
This is a good swim. So we're going to have a campfire tonight or what?
Yeah, later on I think we should,
I hate you! You put me off. Walk that slow, big legs!
I remember the premiere was, on Friday the 13th.
We had a football game right before the actual showing of the movie on opening night.
It was supposed to start right at 10 because they said they didn't want anyone in the auditorium after 11 or 9:30 or something. But the football game wasn't over. But Nino held them off and made sure they didn't start the movie at all until we got back.
Anticipation was high.
We lost the game like we lost most of our games. And I was more excited to go see the movie than I was to be a part of the football game.
We didn't know what kind of turnout we were going to get. We thought it'd be pretty good, but we weren't sure.
I do recall harassing some freshmen at lunch to go see it, and a lot of them were there.
The game was over, and our coaches were all mad about losing, and a couple people were all sad and stuff. And me and Nick Conkle were just like, okay, we're going to go shower. We'll see you later, so.
Aldi's got this fancy suit on. He's all professional about it. He's helping people to their seats, getting everything organized with the equipment. I was extremely excited. I sat down. My parents were there. All my friends were there.
Ended up being a full house. Had to hold people back. Wouldn't let people in because the place was too full.
Of course, I got a front row seat, you know, being a star and all. But watching it was really cool. Like people laughing, you know, interacting with the movie, if you will.
It was just really exciting to see myself on the big screen.
It's pretty fun seeing myself on screen. Had a pretty good time.
It was really cool. And then afterwards, we had an interview with the guy from the Post Crescent. Asked us a couple questions. And
so they watched like the first maybe 15 minutes of it and then left.
Did the article on the front page.
It goes to show how much really goes on in Wisconsin. This movie here is much shorter than the one that had been played at school. Probably a half an hour shorter now. It's I took out the grotesque scene, which I call my deleted scene.
The scene got deleted, I guess, because it was too violent or too bad for a high school kid to have.
I took that out really because the scene was just there to show that there is a killer out. It's actually the first time you actually show the killer.
It was one of the rare times I get two chicks.
Greg Schnazy, who I gave the name Otis, he was in Otis in the credits, even though no one even said his name, but he was wearing a wig, which makes it goofy, and the reason why he was wearing a wig was because I knew I was going to cut off his head and slam it against a wall for an effect, which didn't work, and it just looks goofy.
Another reason why this could have been removed is because of the lack of acting ability, not by myself.
Greg Schnazy is a great actor. A+ in my book.
My co-actors, they were subpar compared to Joe.
I apologize to Nino, because my girlfriend was in the movie. All she could do was walk and say a couple lines, and she couldn't even do it. She's rancid. Rancid actress. Nino, I'm sorry. But you gave it a shot. She did a poor job, I admit it. Poor job. Poor actress.
God bless their hearts. They helped me when I was in need, but...
She's gonna hate you when she sees that.
No, she'll laugh.
But they tried and they did it for me, and it's just still a funny scene to watch. So it'll be there for the deleted scene. I'm not gonna take it out completely, but you can watch that too. After it's all said and done now, after doing this, I can finally push this aside. I've been wanting to do this special edition video or DVD for a long time. Now I can finally let it go. Now I'm almost 21 now, and I shot the first one when I was a junior in high school, and then the second one before my senior year, so I was 17. So now, 4 years later, I can now push it aside. You have Joe, who's doing his, he's in college in Minnesota. Adam's in UWM in Milwaukee. Nick goes to boys' school, MSOU. And, Tony's over in Minnesota, too. I'm out here in Los Angeles now. It's a lot of fun for me to do this. I'm so glad I made these two films. It's like a memory for me, a really fond one. Because editing this, it just makes me laugh, remembering, my friends and things. And, being away for so long, it just helps me remember Wisconsin.
Aldi's a very talented director, I think. I know he's definitely going to be doing something with film in his career. I hope he invites me to tag along some other time. It was a real good time.
It was a good experience. I enjoyed it. I enjoy acting, working with Nino. He's a really good guy.
So what do you think about this tip? Yeah.
I'm going to say action. I want you to wait for 3 seconds, then talk, okay? In 3, 2, 1, action. Darn.
I was counting.
In 3, 2, 1, go.
So.
That's not 3 seconds, though. That was 1 second.
Fine,
that was
fine.
1 second.
All right,
we got to go to our campsite first, all right? With us if you want.
Nah, it's not going to be good enough. You didn't wait long enough.
Trust to get a hospital.
Wait,
or what?
3 seconds.
Sorry. What about the? What about in the shower?
Okay. First of all, I didn't wait 3 seconds. Second of all, I'm not having an orgasm.
It was 20 seconds.
It wasn't 20 seconds because people are laughing. So when I cut, it's going to be people laughing. All right.
Just don't be talking about you.
You got to go loud. What?
I can't stop. I'm not
going to be able to stop now. Do you see him? Anna!
Okay, we're going to have to do that again.
Do you know where he is, Anna?
Yep.
Do you see him, Anna?
I can't hit him in the dark.
Don't move! You're supposed to be a killer. You're not going to get pushed around by some Sally Tim.
Watch what I do. You like?
Okay.
You
well,
like
you're.
This.
Yeah, I will. I
have,
will.
Have this
okay.
foot like
okay.
as much far back.
Here, I'll brace.
Okay.
I'll slow down.
You
gave me a nut shot.
Sorry. I'll slow down as much as I can. You got me. I have too much of a running start.
Your hands. Lay down.
Hold on. Am I passed out here?
Yes.
So don't say anything.
Darn.
Here.
Cut.
I'll move.
Cut.
Can you see my arms? Because they're not tied. Can you see them or no?
Grabbing onto it.
Here. 3 seconds, please God, 3 seconds. Not two, not one, wait, three.
Not getting away from me this time.
Okay, do it again. I didn't even see that. Here, Joel.
Where do you want the axe to be? Hold up.
Why?
You want it to fly open?
No, I'm saying why, stupid bud? Why won't it stay?
It's so bad to fall backwards like that.
Get down from there, boy. It's too high.
Daddy, it's so fun. Look.
Boy, you'll hurt yourself. Fun.
Daddy.
Son.
Daddy, save me, Daddy. Don't let go.
Hold on tight.
No.
Oh. Ow. Owie. Owie scrape.
It's rolling.
That's not gonna work.
Oh my junk. Oh my junk.
You know, normally I'd have to make you guys go out a little bit deeper, but I think I'll let you go.
So,
this is for Kevin. You killed him. You killed him! Now we're gonna pay.
Stop. Stop. Oh my god. Poked right in the head. Poked right.
That looks funny.
I'm sorry! I can't... Steve, I'm your best friend.
No.
Hey, I know that place. That's a place up in Wapak, isn't it? That's probably a really nice place. Probably. So let's see.
Ready? Here
we go. Oh, God.
What?
I saw him reaching for my leg and wouldn't touch it.
Well, I... Hold up.
I wanted to clear my throat.
Just don't look at me. Just look that way.
Ooh, back up.
All right, Theo, you go sit back there.
I thought I had it.
All right, you sit over, go to the bathroom.
No, just sit right here. I can't see you there. Okay. Actually, you can't sit there because you're in a camera. Why?
They said it was pretty nice. You can go there. You know, my parents went camping in Hartman Creek last year. They said it was pretty nice, I guess. Oh, that's not what I say. It's not the words. It's not the words I want to say.
Hey, you should come with me.
No!
I mean...